So, 31 years ago, a wonderful man by the name of Paul Rubens decided to make a movie which would sweep the nation called Pee-wee's Big Adventure. This movie came out 31 years ago. We had a lot of big things, the Pee-wee Herman dance, the song Tequila was infamized. Things about Large Marge and all these great quotes and all kinds of fun stuff. So we know the plot of the movie. Okay, this was a few years before I was born, so I didn't see it till a few years, like early mid 90s or something. So I'd say it was maybe about 8, 9, 10 or something. So thanks to Netflix, it's become a very, very big platform of media, and we've gotten great original shows, great original movies, TV series that have been going on for quite a few seasons, and even some movies that you are only on Netflix. Not that you won't find them on DVD, but you won't be able to see it in a alternative platform. I haven't seen a movie from Netflix come on the DVD yet. I saw one from Crackle, but anyways. So, Pee-wee, he works at a diner. He is, it has the fun music and a light tone and all that stuff. And, he works at a diner, and he is the glue of the establishment. Now, he doesn't want to get, things to change. He's got this music group, and things are changing for them, and so they can't do the group. They're breaking it up, and he's really upset about this, but he doesn't really know what to do because he is like stuck in doing the same type of thing. Now, things can't stay the same forever, and that is true, but in certain circumstances, they can, but without getting into the alternative, totally off-tangent discussion about that, in the movie, they don't. So, come 2016, we have Pee-wee's Big Holiday. Now, it is his big holiday because in walks a mysterious guy who's just badass and stuff. He walks in, and he's like, bam! Pops the jukebox, and then just starts getting music playing, and Pee-wee's just like, whoa, this guy's awesome. So he shows them and everything, and then it's great because it's played by Joe Manganiello, who we know from Sabotage, and we also know as Owen from One Tree Hill, the bartender before Chase. So, what's great is he's like, I'm Pee-wee. And then he's like, who are you? He's like, oh, you're funny. He's like, but I don't know who you are. And he's confused. But he is Joe Manganiello playing Joe Manganiello, which is, that's great. I love it when they do that, fourth wall breaking. And it does something to the movie. It can. Where, you see the real actor the real person actor playing in this movie based on these certain circumstances or events or whatever, and it's very interesting. Now, Joe Manganiello, it turns out that he's like the Escape from Witch Mountain type of brother, like the long lost brother that's like you're the literal second half of me. And so they hit it off right away. Turns out they got a lot of stuff in common. And Pee-wee is like, hey, I want you to. Well, Joe asks Pee-wee if he can show him some, the town. So he shows him the scale model of the town and everything, and Joe's like, hey man, you should live a little because outside past these train tracks, Pee-wee doesn't know what there is. And Joe proceeds to ask him a bunch of questions. He's like, no, I haven't done that, no. And then Pee-wee's like, you know what? I need a holiday. So he tells his boss he's gonna get a holiday and he decides to go. So he's just driving and he comes across some women and so proceeds his adventure. He runs into all these various events and all kinds of fun music and there's a reoccurring theme I won't mention. But the movie is about an hour and a half long. It's a fun movie. It's really fun. He proceeds to have his really big Pee Wee Herman stuff. But there's I think they tried to keep it mostly a lot of it not reoccurring from the movie. More of a fresh thing. And it did. It definitely did feel a lot different from Big Adventure. Dottie is not returning. Unfortunately, at least, that's why, at least I didn't see her, anyways, but it's a fun movie, again, yeah, I like silly movies, again, silly is not bad, silly is my favorite type of humor, and, it's a definitely a fun movie, I definitely think you should check it out, if it's on Netflix streaming, like, it's free, it's right there, watch it, right there. And yeah, so Paul Rubens does a great as Pee-wee Herman once again, 31 years after. And I know they had Pee-wee's Playhouse, but I mean in terms of movies, this is 31 years. I think there might have been another Pee-wee movie I'm missing. I think there might have been one where he joined the circus or. Or something. Let me see if I can find anything. But yeah, so far the Pee-wee's Big Holiday. It was a fun movie. Joe Manganiello. There was a bond that they shared, and it was nice. It was good. Pee-wee's Big Holiday, Big Adventure, Pee-wee Herman Show, Big Top Pee-wee. Oh, okay. So there was okay. So it's been 30, 35, 60, 70, 80, 31, 30, 29, 20, 28 years since his last actual movie. Because it was called Big Top Pee-wee. And, yeah, it was about where he went to a circus and, pretty sure I saw it. It was a really long time ago, and I don't know. But, anyways, so 28 years. So it was a good movie. But I remember I don't think I liked Big Top Pee Wee as much because it just didn't hit as much as Pee Wee's Big Adventure. Because you hear the name Big Adventure, that's gonna set a tone in your mind that it's gonna relate to all these awesome circumstances, homeward bound of just silliness and possibilities and stuff. But yeah, I did like it. I do like when they have big actors in movies and stuff. And I definitely think that they should do another one or something, maybe a Netflix series. I don't know, we'll see. Point in case, Pee-wee's Big Holiday, thumbs up, great, and it retains the classic Pee-wee, so there you go.